Hi guys, welcome to the tutorial on OWASP ZAP. In this series, we will learn how to use ZAP to security test or pen test a web application. In this video, I'm going to provide a high level overview of ZAP and its main features. Subsequent videos will go into these features in more details. So, what is ZAP? It's a tool to find vulnerabilities in a web application. It is open source and completely free. It is cross-platform. That means it can be installed on Windows, Linux, or Macs. It's very easy to use for beginners. For beginners who want to get their hands dirty in the security or pen testing. It is used by professionals too. Since it is used by beginners, that doesn't diminish its quality or functionality. It is very rich in functionality required for any kind of pen testing or security testing. It can be used in CI/CD for automated testing. CI/CD here is continuous integration and continuous delivery. It works very well with other tools, for example, BubSuite. Okay, before we proceed further, there is a caution actually. It is very important to note that you should only use ZAP on your own applications or the ones you have permission to test. Please do not point it to just any website and start firing your tests. So let us go into the main features of ZAP. First and the foremost feature is intercepting proxy. As you can see on the screen, it sits between the browser on your machine and the web application. Any messages you fire to the web application, they go via ZAP proxy. And consequently, any responses coming from the web application, they also go through ZAP proxy and then received by the browser. Next main feature is the spider. The spider can be used to crawl the application to automatically detect all the links and pages, then recursively use the links on those pages to discover even more pages. You can see what messages have been sent and received when a spider is run. The passive scanner just examines the requests and responses which are sent between your browser and the application, but it can still detect certain types of vulnerabilities just by scanning these messages. This can be run safely on any application under test as it does not perform any attacks. The active scanner also examines the requests and responses but performs a variety of attacks on the application under test. So please ensure that you have permission to test before running any active scan on any application. ZAP can also be used to fuzz parameters. You can use fuzzing to find more vulnerabilities that scanners could not highlight. We will see how to use fuzzing in the future videos. Next main features is reports. ZAP can generate reports on the issues found, including advice and links to more details about the problems and how to solve them. A lot of extensions are available on the ZAP marketplace that you can use with ZAP. You can also extend ZAP yourself as it is open source. ZAP supports dynamic SSL certificates, so you can generate a unique root certificate allowing ZAP to intercept HTTPS traffic. Finally, it is important to note that not all types of issues can be found using any automated tools, be it ZAP or Burp or any other security testing tool. And you also need to perform manual security tests to highlight any additional issues. A penetration tester would use a wide variety of tools to pen test an application, and ZAP is certainly one of those tools, which is free and rich in functionality. Thanks for watching.